Steve-O. Tonight, we have DJ Easy Mike here, and we have Steve-O here tonight. Roll the opening. Sensible citizens of America and the world, Canada, of course, Australia, England, and Africa, France, Japan. Steve-O and I are here tonight, and we're going to have a sensible chat tonight, a makeup chat.
You know,
almost.
I've got to tell you, Tom, for my last visit here, right? I showed up like, really, you know, the way I describe. The way I felt showing up here was frustrated and angry, you know, about the television the fucking television industry and its censor happy ways.
Yeah, yeah.
Now I just thought to myself, Tom, I'm just gonna show up at your house and go absolutely fucking bonkers.
I have to say it was amazing. I almost said it was effing awesome, but maybe we could refrain from that sort of speak tonight.
And the thing is, you know, like, it upset a lot of people, you know, to see me the way.
Oh, it really did it?
It did.
You've said that, and I know this, but
it upset people
because it was a wild show. Well, I was worried about you. First of all, I don't know what these whippets are.
Yeah.
So until after the show, everyone said, you know, oh my God, he did a lot of those whippets.
Yeah.
You know, and I'm thinking, well, he's a circus performer. He knows he's probably not inhaling. Is what I said.
I mean, hey, you know what?
Or like, maybe he's got oxygen in there or something, you know. I took one off of it and didn't seem to do that too much to me.
Yeah, you know, I mean.
Was there nitrous oxide in those canisters?
Yeah, dude. I mean, I got fucking wasted when I came here. I came here too. I told you when I was agreeing to come over here for my interview, I said that I demanded light a joint the first thing that I do. Mm-hmm. Light a joint, you know, marijuana.
It was outrageous.
Yeah, and then next thing you know, you've got me chugging hard liquor for 4 hours.
Having a drink like some gentleman. You know, I don't know what all this nitrous oxide is. But,
You know, so to put it like mildly, I upset.
It got out of control.
I upset a lot of my loved ones.
Some of your friends and family were upset.
They were very upset about it, and now like so that spawned this thought.
It was
process,
funny though, you know? Right?
Yeah, people did find it amusing. I thought it was great. I had a blast. Yeah,
I mean, I believe we both vomited at one point at the end of the program.
Yeah,
at the end of the broadcast.
But now this whole experience, you know, like has spawned this thought process. You know, where I've actually like I'm. Philosophizing about like what I do and you know like what I do ultimately is to sacrifice myself for the benefit of humanity at large.
Yeah, that's
you know,
what you're saying.
I was describing that the last time I was here.
You got your arm caught up a horse's ass. You were saying before the show or
right,
something, right?
Right. Shit like that. Yeah. You know they love that fucking.
What was
shit.
It before the show you said about PETA?
Yeah, the last time I was complaining about how much I hate animal abuse in the circus, and that actually got like isolated and placed on PETA's website. And you know, I've since had the PETA send a crew over to my house and sit down and talk about, you know, like I think that it's really pretty much of an asshole move to kill an animal and not even bother to eat it.
Right, sure.
You know, I mean, I don't eat mink, so I don't wear.
Oh, you don't
mink fur. No, I don't.
You don't eat mink. Okay. No, Easy Mike is also a vegetarian as well. No,
he said he doesn't eat mink.
Mink. I eat meat.
Oh, you eat meat. Okay. Yeah, I figured you would be a meat eater.
Yeah.
Steaks and stuff. You like eating steaks?
Yeah, I do. You know, like, I think the healthiest diet includes meat. You know, so fucking, you know, like to. Oh. You know, but okay. So now here's the deal, dude.
For
like,
health reasons.
It's kind of a dilemma
he
for me,
care
but
about animals, it's for health reasons, right?
I'm becoming more positive in my life, you know, like purposefully, you know. And this like was kind of a landmark like thing for me. Like, I realized that, you know, in my work and in my lifestyle, that I amuse a great many people, and I benefit their lives when I carry on the way that I do. But I'm benefiting a great many people at the expense of my loved ones. You know, yeah. People who, you know.
Well, you
and
don't,
then, so then I find myself weighing. It's like,
you don't
it's
have
like
to,
what's the greater good, yeah. You know? It's like, is entertaining millions of people and making their lives better, you know, enhancing their lives, millions of people, yeah. Is that weigh like heavier on the scale?
There, look, at this, look at this then, shot right here, though. Is some? I mean, this is some good Webo vision, though. You have to admit, as filthy and disgusting as it looks now, it also is, you know.
Yeah, that's the kind of thing that could really upset, you know, let's say, a family member.
No, I know exactly what you're talking about. What you're talking about.
So now, like, I'm not really here to say that I'm going to fucking clean up my act.
Like, you probably don't even know how much I know what you're talking about.
You know, I did come here to be sensible and sober. I really don't expect my attitudes, you know, like, to be any different than when I'm completely wasted.
Absolutely. Yeah. No, I mean, look, we can have
I'm
a good time.
Good
we can have a good time. And kids, stay in school. Let's take a call here. Hello, you're on the air. You're on the air here.
Talk to us.
You're on the air here. Hello?
Hey, Tom, it's Frank Sinclair.
Hey, how are you? You have a question here for Steve-O tonight. We're having a sensible chat tonight. Maybe you'd like some advice.
Well, actually, I wanted to ask Steve-O if he was going to do any other movies besides just the Jackass movie.
Yeah, I'm so glad that you asked that. Because, you know, I've got a big-time fucking movie premiere tomorrow night. I got another movie coming out.
Well, tomorrow night it's coming out?
Well, yeah, tomorrow night's the premiere. The next day it comes out.
Oh, what's the movie called?
It's fucking National Lampoon's TV, the movie.
Oh, really?
And
oh, cool.
I'm, get this, the number one star. the first name in the credits. Yeah. You know what that means? I have top billing.
Yeah, above yeah. above the title.
Big-time
yeah,
movie
cool.
star.
And you have a poster?
Yeah, fuck yeah, the only guy on the
that's
poster.
That's kind of fun when there's a poster.
Oh, and, yeah. Love yeah. that fucking yeah. shit. Are you kidding me?
You're going to frame the poster? And
yeah. Oh, yeah, dude.
Where are you going to put the poster? Up on the wall at your house or something?
That's fucking right.
Really? Yeah. Are you going to look at it or what?
I'm going to look at it. I'm going to stare at it. Endlessly.
Hello. You're on the air with Steve-O. Hello.
Dude, listen.
Oh, God.
I've been doing cock push-ups.
Huh?
You lay down flat on the ground, and then you let your lift you up.
Yeah, these guys like playing. He says that's copyright infringement. He's playing Tenacious D into the phone.
Oh, is that what that was?
I think there's a lot of excitement.
Well, yeah. Kyle from Tenacious D, yeah, right, is going to be coming here tonight on Poolside Chats with Neil Hamburger after this broadcast at 9 o'clock p.m. Pacific time out right here by the pool. That'll be exciting. So maybe we need those whippets or something. Huh?
I mean,
we get out the tequila. At least. Time to get out the tequila, I think.
You know what?
I could use a drink myself. You know, I mean, we're going out tonight after the show.
Yeah, we are gonna get fucking plastered.
Yeah, I mean, I personally have to start now. I think. I don't care what your friends and family have to say about it. I'm getting drunk on my show.
Oh my God!
Wait, hey, Mike, hey. Do you have any beats?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Is it time to rap?
Yeah. Well, no. We don't have
I
to
see,
yet.
Dude, no, I see,
dude. I have to have that drink first, I think. But,
all right,
but
you son of a bitch. Bring me a fucking screwdriver. Yeah.
Yeah, a screwdriver. Two screwdrivers over here.
Woo!
Hello, you're on the air on the National Webovision.
Big time.
Hello. Hello, you're on the air.
I was wondering, Steve-O, what do you think about illegally downloading Jackass and Wild Boys on the internet?
You know, it's fucking my attitude is that before somebody doesn't see my work, fucking A, illegally download it, man. I want my art to be fucking seen. I don't fucking care if you pay for it. Fucking download away.
Yeah.
You know, that's what I mean.
I agree with that.
Yeah. You know, I mean, I create my art to fucking for it to be goddamn seen. You know?
Yeah.
I'm not going to, like, withhold it, you know?
Yeah.
And it's my art, and I'm very passionate
people
about
people, ultimately, when they see it on the internet, will then want to go get the whole package.
I think that, I do think that, yeah, the downloading, you know, generating interest and awareness, I think the doctor ourselves.
Yeah.
I think that, yeah, I'm all about viral video, illegal downloads.
Oh my God! Look at that, Zach Wolk, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, Did you come with Zach?
Yeah, he did. And
you've been hanging out with Zach, right?
Yeah, and you know
how cool
pay.
Is that for Zach? It's you got to understand.
Well, that's the only payment he gets.
Well, yeah, I know, and he likes it. I'm starting to feel bad about this.
He's telling me, because I'm asking.
Pepsi, could Pepsi or somebody just come on and advertise here so I can pay them? I'm going to have to start paying the poor guy. It's getting embarrassing. He's booking all, like, you got you to come on the show.
Yeah, dude.
You know?
Well, you
Val Kilmer was here on Monday. Andrew Dice Clay is coming back. Do you ever, you know the Dice man?
I don't, and I'm curious. I was actually asking Zach on the way over here. Is he really, like, is he like two different people, kind of? Like, there's like the him no, performing, or is he always just kind of?
I think he's a performer. First of all, I spent an hour with him, and there was a couple of times where I wasn't sure if I was about to get decked. You know what I mean?
But
it's in fun though.
He's a performer. Antagonizing?
No. I actually just said, hey man, like that at one point, and he said, don't you hit me, and he started sort of getting a little aggressive with me. But I realized that I think it was just him kidding around with me, trying to scare me. You know?
Yeah.
You're not 100% sure.
But I'm not 100% sure.
So you're a little nervous about him coming back?
No, I'm excited about him coming back. I really am. We talked after the show, and he's really into the channel here, and you can sit here and shoot the shit all night, you know, and swear and talk.
Yeah, you know, it's amazing. We got a lot of people.
Who else I ran into?
I'm going to go ahead.
I ran into Norm MacDonald. Do you know him?
What?
Ran into him the other day. I want him to come by. Huh? Okay, hello. Yeah, you're on the air. Let's keep this moving along now.
Hey, Steve-O, I was wondering what it was like working on the OC.
You were on the OC?
I did. I decided to fucking break into acting, so why wouldn't I start off with a major network television sitcom called the OC? Of course. Play a fucking Marine, you know, and I'm pretty militant about doing shots and getting wasted.
Are you on there regularly, or?
No.
You on an episode, or?
It was just a weird offer that came to me, and yeah. What was it like? It was a lot of fun, you know. I had him laughing, you know. I felt like I did a pretty good job.
Yeah. Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Texas, and right now I'm on the Steve-O chat board.
Woo! Yeah!
And Fluffy Von Poopmeister wanted to make sure that we said hi for her.
That's absolutely lovely. Tell Fluff. She helped me film some fantastic skateboarding.
You know Fluff?
I do.
I'm
so fucking passionate.
Do you know Fluffy too, or am I the only one?
Yeah, she's a bit lovely.
This is on your website?
Lovely, yeah.
Where do we people go to go there?
Jen, how should I handle this? Okay, see, like, I've been tweaking around this.
Right, can we show your tattoo? I know everyone's
seen it. Yeah, shit fuck.
It says the F word there on your hand. There.
Yeah, yeah.
Shit fuck. shit fuck.
I've been tweaking around this new website.
I mean, I know I probably just don't pay a lot of attention, I did not notice that last time that it says shit fuck on your hands.
Oh, you did?
I did not know that.
Well, we were pretty wasted. You know what? I want to fucking. I've got so much cool shit to promote, dude, and plug and fucking all that shit.
Let me talk about shit fuck for a second. How come I didn't know that? How come everybody in the planet does not just know that you got shit? Or everybody probably does.
You know, there's not a lot of people.
Oh, is Jen there?
Everyone does know. I just don't know.
You know, like, when you've got shit fuck.
Shit fuck.
When you've got shit fuck tattooed on your knuckles, like, that could be, you know, for other people, that could be like a real job blocker, you know? Like,
yeah.
I mean, that could be a family blocker, you know? Like, bitches wouldn't want to marry you.
Yeah.
Because you have shit fuck on your knuckles.
Yeah.
You know, next thing you know, people don't want you around their kids.
Yeah.
My niece is fucking 4 now. The family's fucking coming down on me about my lifestyle and fucking...
about the shit fuck on the hands?
And then tattoos, they fucking... Has anyone
suggested that you block out the shit flick?
I could change it.
Dice or something like that? Or
when I'm shooting television, I get a scripto marker and I change the T into a P, you know? So it's a ship.
Oh, ship.
And then the F I change into a B. And the U I change into a
ship book.
Ship book. I make two O's.
Oh, ship book.
Ship book. To promote nautical literature.
Oh, we should do that right now. This is the show.
Give me a script.
It's on here, a ship book. Let me do that.
Yeah.
We should do the ship book right now.
Yeah.
Nice, sensible.
I know. And, you know, like, when we were filming Jackass and Wild Boys, like, it would always be a different, like, we'd be writing, like, whore, poon, you know? Yeah, like, whatever. We try to make it even, like, worse.
This is sensible time. Sensible time. We can have a screwdriver, you know, and a cup of coffee.
Exactly.
And go out and have a night on the town, but we don't have to have shit fuck written on our hands tonight.
All right. All right, so exciting news.
Okay.
National Lampoon's TV, the movie. We got fucking 50 screen.
Yeah.
The fucking wide theatrical release. I mean, I'm talking, we're in New York, we're in LA. Like, we got fucking 50 screens. big time movie star because
50,
we were,
oh, 50 screens.
It was
okay.
Looking like it was gonna go to DVD, dude.
Oh, okay.
But
so is it playing in LA?
Yeah, yeah, I got a premiere tomorrow night. I'd like
Where's
to invite
it gonna be
you
playing?
To it. Yeah. I'd like to invite everybody to my premiere.
Tomorrow night. Okay,
tomorrow
yeah.
night. It's going to be in Westwood.
Sure.
Yeah.
We'll bring video cameras.
Okay, so I'm a big time movie star. Yeah, bring video cameras, do whatever you want. Yeah. And, you know, last time we were doing a little rapping together. Mm-hmm. Since then, I flew myself to New York.
Hi, Jen.
Yeah.
Thanks for your call.
Since then, I flew myself to New York. I met with the president of Universal Records to talk about doing a comedy gangster rap album. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you phoned in on
that's goddamn right. And dude, I'm at the point in negotiations, right? Yeah. Like they want to do a deal ASAP.
Yeah, no, you told me. This is exciting. And want, they, yeah. Easy Mike's going to do all
they,
the beats.
Yeah, they want to do. They don't want to. They want to do a deal ASAP. And I'm at the stage where it's a. Draft memo, draft deal memo emails that I don't read.
Do you have to dance?
But it sounds.
Do they
to
make
me,
you? Do they say you have to dance?
I'm gonna make a video for every goddamn track on my album.
But with dancing in it, are you gonna dance?
I'm gonna be dancing my fucking ass off.
Yeah.
Yeah. Jesus.
Cheers.
Cheers, Tom.
Dancing your ass off on Universal Records.
So I'm going to just have a track for a video for every track.
What kind of hip-hop record is it going to be?
It's going to be...
Serious?
No. Come on. It's going to be a fucking comedy gangster.
But is there going to be one song that's sort of moving or anything like that? You know how always the rappers have one with the so slow
the one that I'm going to approach 50 Cent to record with me.
Like a real like growing up was tough but I came back and rocked it.
No, it's actually the song I'm planning to record with 50 Cent is called I Got Guns.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, you
that sounds like a fucking hit to me.
Dude, it's fucking.
Yeah, we got a beat here for
all
your
guys. Yeah.
Check this out. We got a microphone. Or do you guys remember?
Yeah, yeah.
Do you remember we have a rapper,
here
tonight.
I am.
You got to set the
here band. I am, and like on the topic of illegal downloads. See, what I'm essentially doing right now is leaking my material.
You're leaking.
I'm leaking my material.
You're leaking the hot new 50 Cent track.
That's right. He's not even on it yet.
Right
I mean,
now.
It's fucking genius.
Right now.
Marketing fucking
tomorrow,
genius.
Everybody, upload this to YouTube. Hot new 50 Cent track featuring Steve-O.
Yeah, this is my first time fucking performing.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's called I Got Guns. Tony Montana, he got shit on me. Fucking guns than you can believe. My shit is real. I fucking get in my face. I'll show you how it feels to fall to the ground while my gun makes a sound. I'll fucking shoot you dead. Your body won't be found. Oh yeah. You are dead cause I commit murder. I got maggots eating you like a fucking burger. I got guns. Shooting them is fun.
I got guns.
I fucking kill people, dude, like it's no big deal. I fucking kill you, and then your family will cry and I will laugh. Then I'll take a bath, fucking, you know, I don't do it like that, dude. Dude, I'm practically freestyling, dude. Here you go.
Steve-O! No, that's awesome. That's awesome. That's, I need another drink before I can rap. We'll rap together at the end of the show. Are you really doing that song with 50 Cent?
I fucking am. I'm gonna approach him. I'm not gonna do it. He's my bro. Excuse me. I'm feeling rappy. Yeah.
Let's take a call. Let's rap again at the end of the show.
Yeah, yeah.
That is, upload that.
I forgot some of my lyrics. There's actually a lot more lyrics that I forgot, but they're written down somewhere.
It's hard to remember.
I know, but the thing is, that's what's so beautiful about the rap studio.
Are you going to tour?
Yeah.
With the rap album?
Yeah, but I'm doing a whole stunt tour. Mm. I'll do a number.
Yeah.
Maybe a few. But it's going to be a stunt.
Maybe you could bring the Keep and a Real crew along for a couple of shows.
Yeah, yeah.
Throw down some rhymes with you. Easy mic. That thing's portable, the turntable's there. Hello, you're on the air.
Hey,
Steve-O.
Yeah.
Where's your favorite place to drink in South Florida?
Fuck, South Florida. That's like where I call home. The Deuce Bar on South Beach. great Bloody Marys, you know.
Really?
I used to be a big-time cokehead. I mean, this is a place where you can drink fantastic Bloody Marys.
No, I've actually never done cocaine in my
That's
life.
Good. That's good.
I can say that. I can honestly say that.
Cocaine is good.
Cocaine, I've never done that.
I'm almost 10 months off it. You know what? Never mind.
But what does
just saying, I've been around cocaine a lot.
What
you know,
does it actually
do all over
to
the
you
fucking
when you sniff
you know,
it,
you know what it does?
You snort it up your nose.
You know, I mean, I don't want to make it sound bad. I mean, it personally, it makes me fucking totally annoying because I'm like, anyway,
right,
you know?
Right.
But what it does, it just takes sort of like whatever you're passionate about, you know? Like whatever
Amplifies
makes you more, yeah, it amplifies.
For how long?
That's exactly the word I was
going for. For how long?
Well, I mean, you fucking like, keep piling up your nose for as many days as you want.
You just got to constantly be snorting
it. And it makes you talk a lot.
Where do you do it? Do you carry it around in a little bottle or something? Or?
I don't do it anymore. I don't. It's been almost 10 months.
I've never done it. I saw it once on the Keeping It Real crew tour. We were in Saskatoon. I walked into the motel. We were staying at a travel lodge. I walked into like room 36, and there were two girls from Saskatoon, and one of them said, "Want to do some coke?" And I actually ran. I was crying. I wasn't crying. Hello, you're on the air. I wasn't crying. You're on the air. No, well, it's good that you quit.
Take your hat off.
I hear it's bad for you.
I
think I should maybe try it once in my life. But no, that's not true.
It is incredibly bad for you because, I mean, like, to be healthy, you really got to get to sleep, right? You got to eat.
Yeah.
And this fucking shit cocaine, it makes it fucking impossible to eat completely.
You just can't eat.
You go for a fucking day. I would fucking, like, 3 days in a row without eating a fucking thing and not a wink of sleep for 3 days in a row. That's unhealthy.
Well, yeah.
You know, and I would be like 3 days on, like one day of the sleep.
But you don't sleep for 3 days.
And then I get up and then do it again.
What do you do in the middle of the night when everyone else is sleeping? Just walk around or something? Look at stuff or what?
I Google myself on the internet, dude. That works for days. For days! speaking of which, okay, I got more exciting stuff. You know, I got the National Lampoon's TV, the movie, starting this weekend. Mm-hmm. It's fucking funnier than shit. Mm-hmm. You know, I've got the record deal in the works with Universal. Mm-hmm. And I'm dropping a fucking solo DVD project. Now, get this, okay? It's fucking like it's a stunt video.
Yeah.
Except now the premise of this video, it's called Steve-O Paparazzi Stuntman. Mm-hmm. The premise of this video is that I gotta invade the privacy of somebody. My mission statement.
Yeah, you told us about this. Yeah, yeah.
Mission statement in the beginning.
You're gonna go to a celebrity's house.
Well, yeah, I mean, yeah, that's what I did. You know, like your part, you know, I got you in there. You know?
But you're going to walk
very, very quickly.
You're going to walk right into people's houses.
Well, you know, like
and just destroy the house.
There's something going on in every scene.
Would you walk into Warren Beatty and Annette Bening's house and just smash the piano?
You know,
and film it all.
I would try not because that like wanton vandalism. I don't endorse.
You can get it like,
and that's illegal too.
Okay, so what kind of stuff are you gonna do?
Well, you know what? I fucking got a goddamn trailer for you, dude, and it's fucking locked and loaded, dude. Let's see it. Yeah, woo!
Too damn professional. Huh?
Yeah.
Okay, go run that.
Oh.
Look at that.
Every shot.
Oh.
City of chock fucking full of celebrities.
Oh, wow.
You asshole.
Now, what was that you said?
Dude, you totally robbed me right there. Can you scoot back a little bit, dude?
Cut back to it, Rob.
There was a big fucking impressive graphic that makes people want to, like...
Here it comes.
Yeah, I mean...
We got it. We got the
yeah,
graphic.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. From there. Take
now, wait. What are you doing here? You actually...
I'm at...
Where is this?
That was a player's ball.
This is outrageous behavior.
Okay, chock full of celebrities, right? Steve, a paparazzi sent me. See?
Huh? Fuck. Oh, nice, nice. Yeah, oh, the graphic. Yeah, of course.
Yeah,
you don't cut away from the graphic at the end, you fuck. You fuck. You stupid fuck.
God damn. So that's an exciting project, man. Like, there's I got celebrities, like, in every fucking scene, dude. It's
so wait, what was that, a mangina
It was a mangina backflip, also known as the double back back.
A mangina backflip.
Yeah, a mangina backflip, yeah. Also known as a double back backflip.
Wow, and you would, of course, just...
I thought I was going to rip my goddamn dick off first time I fucking did that.
Are you not worried about some sort of serious, long-lasting physical harm of any sort?
You know what? I think that a positive mental attitude makes, like, STDs stay dormant and stuff, you know? Like, you know what I mean? Like,
going in the radiation...
A good mental attitude.
The radiation thing? You said as you were going in, you sort of gleefully whispered over to me, that'll kill you.
Well, that's what they say, dude.
But, I mean, well, if they say it, maybe you shouldn't do it then, maybe.
That won't fucking kill me until I'm, like, 50, though.
Oh, okay. Well, doesn't that worry you? What happens then?
I fucking just saw the opportunity in post-tsunami Thailand to fucking get on that goddamn belt, and I knew that was fucking
Where
weird.
Were you? What
I knew
was
that was class. See, there,
that was the radio. That was the bomb example. Sniffing thing at the airport.
This is another example of what I'm talking about. It's like I'm compelled to do this fucked up shit to fucking entertain people, and it kills. It just kills my loved ones, you know.
Well, that one sounds a little silly.
My dad got really upset with me for the radiation. Yeah. He said that I'm actually in the highest possible risk bracket for cancer.
I think radiation is overhyped. I think it's overhyped.
Yeah. You know, after, and I came out of the fucking x-ray machine.
I get x-rays all the time. I have over the years because I've got cancer.
I came out of the x-ray machine.
I'm not worried about the radiation.
I asked my friend, right?
I use the microwave oven to reheat hook things.
So I asked my friend after the x-ray machine. I said, dude, do you think I'm going to get radiation sickness? Mm-hmm. And my bro said, it's called cancer, dude.
Yeah.
Oh, and
God.
I was like, what did I do? You know what? What did I think?
What were you
but
thinking?
But I couldn't turn it. I could not do it, Tom.
Well, just be careful. Be careful. Hello, you're on the air.
Hey, anybody got a light, dude, man?
8:30. We're drinking some screwdrivers here.
I've had like one fucking sip, dude. I'm practicing.
Sebo's clean and sober tonight. I am clean.
Anyone got a light over here?
How was it to fight Umaga on Monday Night Raw?
Oh, my God. I am telling you that, you know, wrestling, you know, there's a fictional element to it, this professional wrestling business.
Do you know Kevin Federline?
Yeah.
Because
he
got body slammed recently at a
wrestling thing. Dude, I got annihilated way fucking harder than he did.
You did?
You want to see?
Yo, you've done that too?
Hey, dude, go to the fucking, we're going to play my fucking me getting annihilated. But go to my website again, dude, and click Steve-O gets... Fuck, see Steve get beaten into a complete blackout.
Okay.
Like, I don't remember leaving the goddamn fucking wrestling ring.
This was WWE?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, and it was a 350-pound wrestler.
Oh, here we go. Look at this technology we have here. We can just cut to it on the internet. We're freaking...
Yeah, dude, like...
It's a WebOvision classic moment here.
His dick dog got
to
suck
to
see.
Are you
going to
cut to it, Robert,
or
are you going to keep us in suspense for another minute and a half, you fucking...
dude, cheers, man. Thanks, bro. See, yeah, dude, that's pretty sweet. All right, man, dude, whose dick do I gotta suck to see myself get my ass kicked?
Can you cut to it now, Robert?
Jesus Christ.
Are you gonna have a rematch, Steve-O?
Yeah, I'm gonna probably fucking have to. I got a goddamn TV show coming out on the goddamn USA Network after WWE. You know?
Oh, really? Okay. What's
another
piece
of excitement. It's called Dr. Steve-O.
Oh, really? Okay.
Probably shouldn't rag about that. Oh, yeah, here we go.
Oh, here we go.
You're not gonna fucking believe this. This is gonna blow your mind. Dude, I had a fucking stadium going crazy for me.
Yeah. Well, ladies
and
gentlemen,
being in Los Angeles. And dude, every seat in the Staples Center, every fucking seat is sold out.
In fact, I don't know about you, but two of my favorite movie stars are in the front row. From Jackass number 2, Steve-O!
Dude, they've been going crazy for me, dude.
At the Staples Center.
Yeah, oh, dude, now I showed up to do two things, Tom.
Oh, wait, are our mics on? Okay, they can hear us. Okay, good. You can.
Yeah, yeah.
What's up, guys? How you doing? You doing all right?
We're doing great, man. We came here to do two things. Kick some ass. And whoop some butt. Someone's going to hell a little bit early tonight.
Is that Chris?
Yeah, Pontius.
Oh, yeah.
Chris Pontius. It's not me. You dropped your lighter when you dove in, by the way. Guys,
who's
the movie's been very successful,
he's
but
like
I understand you are huge wrestling
like,
fans. You've been WWE fans
awesome.
All your life. Let me ask you, who's your favorite superstar?
I want him on the show.
I know, but dude, you're not
going to get
it. You got to get into it, you know? Like, okay, now you need to. Now there's going to be a little
I like
bit of
Shane.
Espérate. What's that? What might be happening?
Oh.
I might be about to have a confrontation.
Ahora.
Who is that?
He's some guy's fronting on me.
But who is this guy?
Me.
He's the manager of the 350-pound Samoan bulldozer.
My God, now
and I didn't show up to take any fucking
now
shit.
Have you pre-scripted this in any way?
Yeah, we walked through it, but like everything's
crazy things.
Like, so you rehearsed it during the day?
We walked through it during the day.
What's he saying right now to you?
He's accusing me of faking my fucking stunts. Oh. Big mistake.
Right. That you can't stand up to the wrestlers. Okay, let's listen for a second.
Oh yeah, pal. We will do anything.
Thanks, he did.
He told me.
Amigo.
Now I get very serious,
anything.
Tom.
Yeah. I said anything.
Man, that looks like a lot of fun.
Dude,
I have a feeling it's going to get gnarly, though.
Yeah, it's going to get really gnarly.
Listen, listen.
Do anything, I have a friend I'd like for you to meet. And his name is the Samoan Bulldozer.
Umanga. Umanga.
Oh my God! And the loser leaves Raw match. King's now SmackDown.
So you guys are gonna fight this guy. Great.
That's goddamn right.
I'm not sure Umanga.
Yeah, dude, you're not gonna believe the fucking command I have over this arena, dude. I was born for arena rock.
How many people are in this?
Wait,
what website is this coming off right now?
It's like YouTube, whatever.
YouTube, huh? We're watching this on YouTube right now.
Oh my God, dude.
Umanga, if you would like to see this video, you can go to YouTube and what do you punch in?
Yeah. The electricity is fucking incredible.
Oh my God, here, look at this.
Okay, now, dude, check this out.
These guys get run over by.
Now you all have no shirts on. Oh, look at you up.
Okay, here we go, dude. Check out my skills.
We're doing it.
Oh! Yeah.
Yeah, I laid that one down.
That was cool. Have you practiced in a wrestling ring before over the years? Have you done stuff
like
this?
I've been in a few rings, yeah, dude.
That was impressive.
That was impressive. Who's this guy? Can he do that? Oh!
Yeah, it really gets pretty gnarly.
Oh my God.
By
Umanga.
Wow.
Two of the most eclectic stars in Hollywood. Eclectic.
Yeah,
that's
no,
good.
Yeah.
That's it.
You guys are very eclectic.
You see, now this was written in, but I couldn't.
Like, we look at you laughing.
Because you see, dude.
Wait a minute, what goes on here? Are you laughing at him?
Now you gotta pay close attention to these hits.
They think it's
okay?
Funny when each other gets hurt.
Oh!
Not fun.
Yeah.
That was not fucking fun at all.
A lot of timing involved here. Now, does that hurt?
That fucking hurt like shit, and then I get knocked into a blackout.
That actually did hurt, though.
Yeah, that
it's
fucking
not
hurt.
Fake. Wrestling is not fake.
No, he was pissed off at me for laughing about all this whole ordeal.
No.
Yeah.
Wrestling's fake, I thought.
Oh! That fucking hurt like shit. Okay, now, dude, look, you got like, he kicks me, and then he punches me a couple times. The next two punches to my head are the ones that knocked me out. I forgot to fucking play dead, dude.
Yeah.
So you're supposed to play dead, and then
yeah. Oh.
Yeah, look at this.
Oh! What?
Yeah,
that looked really bad.
It was really bad.
Did he hit you for real?
Yeah. Oh. I was crying. They don't show the end of the match. That was such a fucking disturbing mess.
Oh, really? So this guy's really mad at you?
Yeah. Why see, like, that's where they cut off.
Okay, cut away from this. This is disgusting. This is outrageous.
They don't even show
Robert, stop this. This is outrageous.
Yeah, they don't even show the end of it, you know, like, because I was so cross. I had a goddamn conversation with billionaire Vince McMahon that I don't fucking remember. I don't remember the goddamn ring to the doctor, dude.
Really?
Practically, I mean, I remember some.
You went to the doctor after that?
They made the doctor come to me in the arena.
Why was that wrestler, what's his name?
Umaga.
Why was Umaga so angry?
Well, you see, I didn't know, dude, that tapping out didn't apply to the WWE.
Yeah.
I thought you'd tap yourself out and they'd leave you alone.
No, yeah.
No, that's not how it works. And then the other valuable...
Umaga just slaughtered you.
I know. The other valuable lesson...
But no, was he really mad for real? Come on.
Yeah, he was because...
Come on, it's all the
it was supposed to be over
out.
When he jumped off the ropes and landed on me. That was supposed to be over. But my reaction to this
So
was,
when he punched you in the head...
It was fucking gnarly,
it
dude.
Looked, yeah,
gnarly. Really gnarly.
Can you play that back where he punched you in the head? He punched you in the...
Yeah, I
that was real. That didn't can you play the punch in the head back? And we'll take a phone call while you cue that up, Robert.
Yeah.
We're on the air here with Steve-O on the National Webo Vision. It's 8:40.
I was wondering...
I'd like a shot of tequila if that's possible.
Come out.
What's that?
When is Dr. Steve-O supposed to come out?
I don't know. They're not letting me brag about it, but here I go. I don't know. Like, we don't have an air date yet. But I made this fucking show so goddamn good.
How do you make a show? I mean, for the kids out there that want to know. I know how to do it, but I mean, you know.
Well, I mean, for me, you want
to
ask
what's
me.
Involved? Like, well, you have to go over there and you have to do all these stupid
meetings, you do a bunch
of meetings, right?
Yeah, creative meetings. You got to have a fucking
game. And then
do
some people come in, like, and they kind of, like, look at all the jokes and then they kind of write
stuff?
I don't
want to put down, the production company I'm working with is the same production company that created Real World, Road Rules. They do The Simple Life with Paris Hilton.
Buna Murray,
exactly.
Yeah, that's
so I'm working with Buna Murray. And
but do they ruin it, is what I'm asking you. I'm not telling you to say mean things about Buna Murray, but do they ruin the show?
The nature of the television industry is that everything starts at the fucking last possible moment, and you're up against the wall, and you're running through it. So I run
exactly.
In.
Why is that? Can you explain that
to people? I have no idea why that is. But
every time.
But I
because nobody wants to say you're actually allowed to do it until the last minute.
I know.
And it's like, okay, we'll do it. By the way, can we have it Wednesday?
Yeah. And like, I'll come in, like, I mean, at least this is my
you want to do
my
a shot
experience.
Tequila?
I'm cool.
You sure? Really?
Yeah, I'm good. Maybe in a little bit.
Right.
But, you know, I'll come in and, you know, in all reality, they'll have a fucking, you know, like, production plan scheduled, you know, with all these ideas and shit, and I'll be like...
So you'll go in, there'll be like a chalkboard up on the wall?
And I'll be like, I'm not doing that, you know, like, and then...
It'll be like, on the wall, it'll be like, Wednesday. M60's in the ass.
Yeah, pretty much.
Tuesday.
Yeah, that...
Whack off the horse, you know?
Yeah. Shit like that. But yeah, like the shit I don't want to do, or if I think it's mean spirited, like, you know, I mean, we see like Bam's, you know, had a successful.
What's his name?
You as
what's
well.
His name? Bunim. What's his name again?
John Murray.
John Murray. Yeah. Oh yes, that's right. John Murray. I've met him before. Very nice man.
Yeah.
What do you think he prefers? A good sort of whack off, sort of cum related joke, like cum coming out of a horse's cock.
You know what? Like, I think.
Or.
It's a really positive show. Here's the premise of my show.
What is the show?
It's called Dr. Steve-O, where I've got my, you know, I just introduced myself.
I bet I shouldn't have had that shot. I just replayed the sentence I just said, and I feel horrible about it. I said something about a horse and a...
Yeah.
Oh, man. Thank God no one's watching.
Yeah. Okay, so the show is, I'm going to de-wussify America. Mm-hmm. You know? I've got guys that are sending me in videotape applications. They want my help to be able to, you know, stand up for themselves more. We're talking about type B personality, real geeks. You know, big time sort of, you know.
You're
going to
de-wussify them.
De-wussify them.
You show
exactly.
up at their house.
Yeah, I fucking kidnapped these sons of bitches. You know, I kidnapped these sons of bitches. Now I'm in trouble with the law. You know, I got no driver's license. I got a hot chick driving for me.
So it's kind of like pimp my ride, but it's more like pimp my entire being.
Yeah, you know,
pimp my carcass.
Yeah, I didn't even know what I was getting into, but you know, I hear these guys.
Have you shot one yet?
Yeah.
Okay,
totally.
Tell
and
what
it's happened. On air pilot. Too,
where did you shoot it? Indiana,
Riverside, California, the crystal meth capital of the world.
And what happened?
It was fucking amazing, dude. Like you got to hear these guys that you know are like really just not going for it in life, you know? And you know, like you see them just have a great time with me, and I put them up to some pretty scary challenges.
Was it like some college kids or high school
not high school, you know, more college age, you know?
You guys drink?
Like one of the guys is
a drunken mess?
I was drunken mess like at night, but that's actually wrapped.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Serious show, man.
I'm keeping it fucking all professional, positive. I'm trying to make the world a better place.
They did the simple life, right?
Yeah.
And Nicole, your friend Nicole, did that show with this company.
Right.
So you probably have a lot of insight on how to make these kinds of shows.
Yeah, that's exactly right. I pride myself on making pretty good goddamn television.
Did Nicole help you with those?
I don't know. There was a rap song.
We don't care about tabloid type salacious.
Yeah, if there's anything I love, it's being in goddamn tabloids.
Yeah. Hello, you're on the air. You're on the air.
I was wondering, what's the worst stunt that's ever gone wrong?
I don't know. Probably when I burned my face off the one time I had these gnarly second-degree burns. I don't know. Google it, dude. Worst injury, whatever.
You could also use the TomGreen.com search function. Hello, you're on the air.
Hello, Tom. It's Brad.
Yes, hello.
Grant, no way, dude. All the way from Australia.
It's sensible.
England, dude.
England.
Oh, it's Brad. I thought it said Grant. Yeah, what's up, Brad, dude, bro? Here's a guy who's completely covered in tattoos of me, dude. I flew myself out to England.
You know this guy?
Of course I know this guy. Come on, dude. You have no idea how...
You've personally known everyone who's called the show so far.
That's goddamn right, dude. It's because I fucking am... I think out of all celebrities... And I don't even think I'm exaggerating here. I think I'm more attentive to my fan base on the internet, and I communicate more with my fans, and I fucking love them more than fucking anyone.
Anyone.
Yeah, you know? Goddamn right I know all these people. I flew myself out to London to eat my favorite pickled onion-flavored corn snack and to give my first tattoo. I tattooed my autograph on this son of a bitch.
Wait. I want to analyze the last sentence. You flew out to London to eat what?
My favorite pickled onion flavored corn snack. It's called pickled onion flavored Monster Munch. I'm absolutely fanatical about it. It's only available in England.
And you went there and got it with this guy and tattooed this guy.
I tattooed my autograph on this guy. This guy's covered in fucking tattoos of me.
You guys also like in love with each other?
I fucking tell the guy, I say, fucking dude, I love you, bro. Yeah, dude, I fucking tell
him. Just tell him right
now. Yeah, I love you, bro, dude. And fucking, I just saw him a couple days ago. He's calling from London, England.
Yeah.
We just premiered our movie, Jackass Number 2, which is still killing it in theaters.
Good. And, talk to him right now.
To this guy. And I got together with Brad again. I brought him to the London premiere and made him take his pants down on the red carpet to show off all these awesome tattoos of me. Fucking great time, Brad, and I do love you, brother.
Steve, I just want to say thanks for taking us there. And it's just, you know, I don't want to ask you. I just want to say thank you for everything.
How many tattoos of Steve-O do you have on your body?
Five or six, I think.
Wow.
I'm talking gigantic ones.
Can
dude.
We see this anywhere on the internet?
Yeah, we can. If we go on
Can we see who we're talking to right now on the National Webovision?
Hey, Brad, can you fucking email your that strip of the fucking pictures of all the tats?
Do I email it straight to Tom, yeah?
Quite a sensible.
You're not going to believe this
fellow.
Guy.
Quite a sensible.
Oh, fellow. Shit. On my MySpace.
Email it to robert@beefbaloney.com.
You know what, dude? I'll fucking
Robert,
figure this out. Here, dude, I know where
Steve-O's the Steve-O's gonna go get there. This
I got
now, what's
this
your name, sir, again? Grant?
Okay, dude, on my website, what
Grant.
We need
yeah.
is
How
go to
you?
MySpace
where are you
Army.
Right now? What part of the world are you in?
like 10 to 5 in the morning.
No. 10 to 5, yeah.
Yeah,
I know that, actually, because I have a clock here as well.
I'll
should have the England time on the wall for so I can look up and see London.
Okay.
Well, that's what we meant to do on the brick wall. We've been meaning to... Could I have my single, please, Robert? I'll take it myself.
Hey, tell Brad to promote my MySpace page right
Grant,
now.
Grant, can you promote Steve-O's MySpace page right now?
Yeah, it's 2 seconds. I'm going to get it up, actually.
I fucking talk to my goddamn fans every day.
We're on the line with Grant here.
Brad.
Okay. Brad, really? You mind if I call you Grant?
You call me whatever you want, Tom.
Okay.
Well.
Yeah, I got it,
this has been
a
fun night, actually. I've got it.
I have
a lot of fun. I enjoyed playing that wrestling stuff, and just watching that was fun to watch. I think it's interesting how the National Webovision allows you to just kind of go online and say, here's Steve-O's here. He got flipped over in the Staples Center a few weeks ago.
Yeah, all right, dude, I got it, dude. I got it up.
Cut to it, show you.
Dude, you're not going to believe it.
This guy's calling from England.
Yeah, it's my bro. Brad, I got you, dude.
10 to 5 in England right
check
now.
It out, dude. Look
whoa!
At it.
Whoa!
This is on.
Yo, wait. Brad or Grant or whatever you let
it's
me
Brad,
call you.
It's Brad.
Grant. hey, Grant. We are looking like, what, at what? Your legs right now. You. Oh, well.
Look at that one, dude. It's incredible.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude. That one's incredible. See, that's where I autographed
it. Yeah. Now, how old are you there, Brad?
I'm 27, bro.
27 years old. And are you married?
Yes, I am.
Well, you are married.
His wife is fucking, you know, like she's a fan as well, you know, like we hang out, friends. Like I love these guys.
Yeah.
I dragged around for a day.
You hang out with him and his wife, do you, Steve?
Yeah, I do, man. I go to London, man, and that's what we do. We kick it.
Wow.
And have a good time, man.
Yeah.
Now, does your wife have any tattoos of Steve-O also?
No.
That would look awfully strange while you
two later.
Made love. It would be like Steve-O fucking himself. Don't cut to me. Don't cut to me
Whoa.
When I say this profanity. Wait, no. Have you done that yet, by the way?
Yeah.
I'm surprised you haven't done that one.
We had this one idea, okay, dude. Funnier than fucking shit. And we were gonna do it.
What are we talking about?
We were gonna do this, right? Me and Party Boy, okay? It's called The Changing of the Guard. Mm-hmm. All right. You know how they have those fucking guards at the Buckingham Palace in London, you know?
Yeah.
And like they're like not allowed to move. We were gonna get one of these hats, right? Okay.
The big bear skin.
Yeah. And it was gonna be like, we're gonna jerk off, you know?
Like actually jerking
yeah,
off.
Yeah, with like the hat
with
on.
With the hat on.
With the hat on, yeah. And then.
Where
then,
would you do this? At Buckingham Palace?
That would probably be the best, you know. But okay, so then you jerk off. Now, you're jerking off by yourself, so it's not gay, you know? And then, like, you. Then when you.
Wait, what?
Yeah, it's not gay. You're jerking off by yourself. You're thinking about chicks. You know what I mean? It's not gay at all.
I hope it's not.
Okay, so then when you reach the point of no return, right? Yeah. When you're about to really shoot your wad. Then your buddy grabs the hat off your head, and then he finishes you off, right? Because you've passed the point of no return. It's gonna happen anyway. So it's not gay, you know? It's the changing of the guard. You know? It actually is kind of gay. That's why we never did it. Now, the thing
you
is,
never did that?
No, I never changed
the guard. I'm glad you never did it.
I know. And now the thing is, dude, now here.
Not that there's anything wrong with the changing of the guard.
Right. And what is it about homosexuals that's so goddamn funny? Because I'm sorry, faggots are fucking funny. You know, and far be it to me, you know, far be it, you know, for me to pick on homosexuals.
So you're saying they're funny. I mean, that's a compliment, in most circles.
And I am not going to fucking be called a guy who picks on homosexuals. For God's sakes, Tom, I play one on TV. I play a homosexual nature expert on TV.
Well, on which program is this?
A program called Wild Boys.
Oh.
It's now.
On Wild
back.
Boys?
Homosexual.
I didn't understand that.
There's been a lot of gay things I've done on TV.
Like what? What are some of the gayest things you've done?
Well, I mean, I stuck a beer bong up my butt, Tom.
A beer
bong?
Up the
hose.
Why? Now,
I had my friends.
There's something that is, I think, universally funny about that.
I know.
Just because it's sort of.
Right.
Obviously, because it's the last thing that you know, you would actually want to do as a heterosexual man.
Right.
You're making
right.
a comment.
Right, exactly. And I'm not trying to pick on homosexuals. What I'm trying to do is rid the world of homophobia and superstition and, you know, all forms of bigotry.
What are some of the other, you know, things that you would put in the gayest things that you've done?
Oh, the gayest? Yeah. Well, like, there's
catering to our gay audience right now who is at home on the internet.
There's been a...
pounding away.
Like we had this one guy. this one guy filmed myself ejaculating on his computer and his phone, which I thought was fucking funny. Yeah, a lot of people think that's funny.
Yeah, yeah. No.
Then there's all this stapling of the... Yeah. If you may have noticed my mangina backflip, a lot of people think that's gay.
Yeah.
You know, a mangina backflip.
That's
pretty gay.
No, I think that's pretty funny, though.
Yeah. Yeah.
I like that.
It's good.
Hello. Hello.
It's great to talk to you, Brad, dude. Fucking love
Thanks,
you,
Brad. Thanks, Brad. Oh, yeah, Brad with the tattoos. I'm sorry, Brad. We should have talked to this freak a little more. Look, now, how do you feel, Steve-O?
Can I ask you a tough question?
Can I ask you a tough question?
Go for it.
Cut back to camera three here for a second. Do you feel any element of guilt when you look at that?
At first, when I saw the first one, I was like, oh, no, what's he done, you know? Now it's just
kind of
like,
it's
glory. So fucking ridiculous. I love it, you know? And I'm not going to lie, dude. It did not last 1 minute, any feelings of guilt. Like, my parents got me like, hey, I fucking love it.
Yeah,
and
it's
I
funny.
Was tattooed.
No, you did it, right?
It's me.
Let's see.
It's
yeah, me. We've seen your
I love
before.
Me.
Yeah.
Everybody loves themselves. Right. I like to, yeah.
So you just are, you're going to have a lifelong bond with this guy.
Yeah.
Whether he likes it or not.
I know. He's one of the people I was describing who, yeah, you know, like the last show that I had over here, you know, it was very upsetting for him, you know. Got a lot of people who care about me a lot, you know, and I talk to my fans every fucking day on my MySpace. I put my blogs out there, you know, let everyone know what's going on. And I really just like come out, you know, like my heart's an open book, Tom. It's all out there. And I'm a good writer. I really put out good shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, pretty proud of it.
I mean... I have had people email me saying that they wanted to go tattoo, like, you know, the channel or something, and I always discourage it.
Yeah.
I don't have a tattoo on my entire body, though. Yeah, not no.
You've got some pretty good scars, though.
Yeah, I don't have. Yeah, I do have some scars, but I don't have. Can we
see one of them?
Yeah.
How about you stop being. Like a chump about it,
I'll show you
and pull
scar.
Out the uniball.
I'll show you one scar.
Let's see the uniball scar.
No, I'm not gonna
Come
show
on.
You the uniball.
Come on. Okay. I want to see the uniball scar.
I want you.
It's not a uniball I'm looking for. It's the scar.
I don't want.
Do you have a scrotal scar?
I don't want the number one gayest thing that you've done on television to involve me in my living room. But I will show you one scar that I have since we're doing it.
Yeah, that's
what,
you know.
I want to ask to see a scar. I have a scar from, do you see it? Here.
Yeah.
Here.
See, you've got good skin like me, dude. Like, you
here,
don't show scars there.
All the way down to there. All the way down. Right.
Now, is that how you got the uniball?
No, the uniball is another scar that I have right.
Is it scrotal?
Right there. That's where they got. Right there is where.
Oh,
they
that's
my
where they went in from the wall.
I've always wanted to show this. They go in right here, and they go down, and then they shuck it out like an oyster.
That's pretty funny, man.
But I like to let the world know that because I want them to know that they don't actually cut the scrotum. It's not like they go in there with a machete and just lob off the right, you know, the ball.
I tell you,
about, I have enough. I'm completely. My scrotum's completely intact.
I tell you about the ongoing.
Never been sliced. Never been touched.
Speaking of my family, you know, coming down on me for my lifestyle and you know my fucking all this. My family's also upset about, you know, I was talking about getting a vasectomy. You know, I was going to, like, fuck.
Who are you, Paul Reiser, all of a sudden? What the hell?
I was going to get a goddamn vasectomy for the purpose of filming. I mean, to me, it is hysterical.
Are you really thinking about getting a vasectomy?
Not anymore, and I think it was more just, like, in theory, you know? It's funnier, like, in theory, I think, than on footage it would be. But, like, the idea was to be the sole entrant, right? in the vasectomy Olympics, you know, which would be, I come off the vasectomy, you know, like off the fucking operating table, whatever it is. And then, you know, like running through the tires, you know, an obstacle course, we'll go up, jump in the seat, and a balloon on the lap, and then the stripper jumps in the balloon, and you gotta climb over the fence. Now I'm thinking to myself, if there's only one person that enters the competition,
yeah,
then that person is guaranteed to fucking win. I would definitely be the champion.
So you're going to not only start your own Olympics.
You know? Right.
Yeah, actually, you would win it.
Yeah, and of course I'd also lose.
Although going by that theory, you could make your Olympic event something other than the vasectomy Olympics, and then you don't
That's
have to
true.
Get a vasectomy.
I know. Yeah. I was thinking about doing the Special K Olympics, you know, snorting a lot of ketamine, because boy, does that make you lose your balance.
Children. At home listening today. It has been a pleasure to have you here tonight.
Oh,
we
yeah,
gotta go
dude.
Out and have
I know,
have
they,
some
we,
fun.
We, you know what, we're gonna do a stalk Val Kilmer.
Yeah. We have
we're
a couple
track that son of a bitch down.
We're gonna go hang out with Val Kilmer.
I heard he was talking some smack about me in the wrestling scene.
No, he was saying
he wasn't.
In the wrestling scene?
Yeah, well, he was talking about wrestling me, right?
I don't know.
He maybe saw me with your manga and he thought
I'm not privy to this.
Okay, wait. I'll kick that chump's ass.
You want to drop a beat to end off the show?
Yeah.
Pass Steve-O a mic here. And now, wait a minute. We have Neil Hamburger out by the pool. Is there a camera out there on the man? Can you cut to Neil Hamburger for a second? Let's talk to the man for a second. Neil Hamburger is out there tonight on poolside chats. There's the set out there, Steve-O. See, that's the set. There's Neil Hamburger. And he is going to be... Neil, who do you have on the show tonight? Neil, who do you have on your show tonight?
Yeah.
Kyle, how are you?
He's
hey,
right.
Kyle.
The internet is
you.
Not
Come
there.
Over here. Camera three. Fuck. Camera three here. Stay, Kyle, stay on to Steve-O.
Hey,
Steve-O. Kyle from Tenacious D is here tonight. You know Easy Mike. He produced your record from the Dust Brothers.
Oh, my God.
And Kyle is on Poolside Chats with Neil Hamburger tonight. So, Kyle, go say hi to Neil Hamburger. Thanks for coming, man. That's awesome.
You know, when you told me about fucking
Kyle,
that show...
Kyle, thanks, man. That's awesome.
I gotta tell you, Tom.
We got a couple of mics over here.
Yeah,
keep that beat rolling.
When you told,
a couple of mics over
when
here.
You told me about the hamburger show, I thought you were gonna feed me fucking hamburgers.
No, it's Neil
yeah,
Hamburger.
Yeah, I've been starving for a hamburger
this is
now.
Annie. Annie likes you. Annie's normally a little more... Annie, come here.
It's okay.
Hey, Robert.
She knows I'm about to fucking lay down.
Oh, yeah.
We did it.
Okay.
Give me a mic, too. I want a mic, too.
I need to...
Can I? Two mics.
It's really happening. Really free shot, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Sorry. But I gotta fucking
we
learn
need
this.
Two mics.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, dude.
Yeah.
I'm in the rap scene. I am fucking hanging out with Tom Green. We're not drunk.
Tom Green.
Okay.
Wait, where's my mic? You got it. I want a mic. I want
some. Oh,
check. Steve-O!
Keeping it clean tonight. That's right.
Turn the beat up a little bit. Okay, turn on the disco lights. We got Easy. We got Steve-O in the house. We got Steve-O in the house. We got Steve-O in the house. Grab the microphone, rip some motherfucking shit out. Steve-O in the house. We got Steve-O in the house. Steve-O in the house. Yo, grab the microphone, bust some shit right out. Yo.
Oh, man. Yeah, fuck. Oh, is there any such thing as rapper's block? Did that happen? Rapper's block. I got a strong cock. What do you say? I'll blow you away.
Rapper's block.
Yeah. I pop quick. I got a small dick. Banging hoes like clicking a pick.
Hey, I got a small dick too. Coincidence. Yo, Steve-O rock some shit like this.
Fuck. Yeah. What?
Say what? Say what? What? Say. Say what? Say what? What? Say Steve-O.
Oh, yeah.
Say Steve-O.
When I get near, the bitches want to hear the sound of my tears landing in their ear. What up?
Landing in your ear.
I come all over.
Come right over here. We got Steve-O in the place. Gonna rock some rhymes. We got Easy Mike. Gonna drop some beats. We got Robert Kurtz over there cutting the camera. Steve-O rocking like this. Na-na-na-na-na. Na-na-na-na-na.
My rhymes are legit. Oh, shit. I will not quit. Fuck
oh,
is marijuana.
Shit.
It's the shit. What?
Now we're gonna pass it over to Neil Hamburger. Steve-O, thank you so much.
for coming on the show tonight.
Thank you.
We are rapping here. We're rapping fools. I want to thank DJ Easy Mike. And let's now go out to the pool. Or do you want to keep rapping for a second?
Steve-O's rapping, it's right, not wrong. Huh? I hit the bar to jump on this song. Huh? I just want to keep rapping with Tom Green. His beats are mean.
Easy Mike. Fucking,
he doesn't smoke the green.
Don't touch that stuff.
He's a rapping machine. I'm still pissed off, dude. When you're dead, it's because I commit murder. I have a fucking magazine here like a burger, dude.
Whoa, burger. Say what? Burger King?
I love that rhyme, dude.
Let me rap now. Let me sing now.
Now it's time to hit the strip. Val Kilmer's going to suck my dick.
What? Say suck, suck.
Yeah, dude, that's fucking right. Because I'm a tough-ass motherfucking gangster, yo. And I got guns, dude.
Tough-ass gangster. Steve-O is a tough-ass. Now we're gonna rock and flow like a prankster. Here we go again, not a wankster. Steve-O, grab the mic, do the shit like you like. Got Easy Mic on the wheels, feel like right. So here we
fuck
go.
Yeah, my albums, they're gonna fly off the shelf, dude. And you know what? K-Fed,
K-Fed can suck Steve-O's, you know, dude, like, dick.
That's the thing, man. Fucking, I'm gonna make my fucking, my rhymes are gonna be fucking funny. And I want a lot of fucking money. So much that my diarrhea won't be running.
What?
Just so much, dude.
What? Steve-O, keep it going, gonna rock like now. Drop a shit right now. Steve-O, keep it going, rock a shit right now. Drop the shit right now!
Step aside, K-Fed, yo! There's a new boy in town, and I don't like to frown. That's why I lay it down. Yeah, cause I'm a fucking gangster!
We got the new shit in town! Fuck K-Fed! We got the new shit in town! We got the new shit in town!
And fuck that asshole fucking Steven Dorff! He's a fucking fag. Well, I got a fucking beef with that guy.
I actually would like, we like K-Fed though, don't we?
Yeah, you know, we actually do like, we like, yeah. K-Fed a lot. Yeah. He's got a small cock.
Wee.
He didn't really know how to rock. But.
Like K-Fed.
But now K-Fed might not know how to rock, but he knows how to roll a good fucking blunt. You know?
Like
his wife has got to have a pretty sweet cunt. You heard about his divorce? I put my arms in the fucking horse, and now K-Fed's getting a divorce.
Good night, everybody. Steve-O, thank you. Let's go out to Neil Hamburger by the pool. Thank you for watching the channel. Tomorrow night, the Tonight Show will be here. Ross, the intern's coming up, and we're going to be talking to Ross all night and taking your calls. Neil?